Hello, my fellow rockers. How are you all doing today? We're going to get started with one of those bad boys right there. And today I have something new, exciting, special. And before I got this video rolling, I always test the product first. And I have to tell you, I was really impressed with this. If you're looking for a microphone, you'll want to pay attention on this one. Very specific reason. Today we are going to talk about 512 Audio. 512 Audio is an Austin-based company, okay? And they make a small number of products. And I have two of their products. Actually, I have four of their products here. I have their headphones. I have their dynamic microphone right here. And I have their condenser microphone right here. And I'm purposely recording the screen here because these microphones are very, very focused. And if you look at the screen, you could see how close both of these are. And by the way, I know they don't look level, but they are. So if I go from where I would talk into the microphone, these are right there. You could see perfectly level. Okay, so it's picking up my voice kind of like right at the same place. It's just the way the camera angle and all that stuff. But these microphones are very focused. So when I talk into this, you could see how little the condenser is picking up. And a condenser, as you know, is very, very sensitive. This one here is the condenser. And you could see how much this dynamic mic is not picking up. So if you wanted to do something like a podcast or something, anything where you really wanted to isolate the vocals, what's right in front of you, these microphones are really good. Typically with condenser microphones especially, they pick everything up, okay? This one seems to be very focused on whatever is right in front of it right here. This one has what's called a hypercardioid. So if I could visualize, this microphone here would pick up like something like that, like whatever is right in front of it. Hyper, meaning hyper-focused. This one here is a little bit, that circle is a little bit more, okay? Regular cardioid, kind of like it's supposed to look like a heart. So it comes out, I'll visualize it, comes out like a heart, okay? This one is a little wider, which makes sense because if you're singing, usually you use a condenser if you're singing and you want to catch that, like, a little bit of that ambient sound of your voice, where this one here is definitely more focused, okay? So let me tell you about both of these microphones, and I'm purposely putting the meter to show you how much each microphone isolates when I'm not talking directly into it. Again, this is the Channel 4 512 Skylight, and this one here is the Limelight. And again, I'm pretty fascinated by this, especially for me, condensers. There's a lot of floor noise where I am right now, and this is dropping everything. In fact, if you look at the panel strip at the bottom, I'm going to stop talking. You could see the dynamic has, like, I don't know if it's called floor noise, but you could see it's picking up less, and this is picking up a little bit more. But if I plugged another dynamic microphone in, you'd see the floor noise would be a lot bigger. So let me stop talking and focus on the bottom track strip. So if you look at what I just tapped on, it's a little bit higher. That floor noise is just a little bit higher. Again, remember, this is a plus 48 dB. You know, power, not dB, 48 volt power to this microphone. This one is not, okay? So this will be a little lower. But again, look over here. And just to show you what's what, I'm going to tap on it and then look at where it drops down to. So it's really rejecting everything around it, which is, again, fascinating for me. Okay, so let's talk about this. This is the Limelight Dynamic Vocal Mic. In fact, while I talk about this, I'm going to completely cut the volume here so you can just hear the dynamic because you're getting a little spillover. Let me cut this. Testing 1, 2, 3. Okay, so right now you are only hearing this. This is a dynamic microphone, 512 Audio Limelight. Okay, it's Sweetwater sponsored this video. Sweetwater sent these over. They sell for $1.99 on Sweetwater. They call this a broadcast style dynamic mic. Natural articulate audio capture. Okay, smooth, rich sound, especially at close range. Hypercardioid polar pattern, again, that tight focused, it's only picking up what's right in front of it, minimal ambient noise. There is a built-in pop shield and low frequency filter, which gets rid of what's called plosives, okay? It rejects that. I think it's the T's and the plosives, the P's and the T's. Industry standard XLR connector. It comes with the swivel mount. This happens to be a really impressive microphone. And I think you have a nice clear shot of what that looks like. It also comes with a bag and it comes with a little adapter depending on what kind of mic stand you're using. It's 50 hertz to 20K. Let's see, 600 ohms, 138 dB. There's a high pass filter switch built into it. In fact, I have them both enabled because, again, where I am, there's that floor noise. I have a furnace running in the background. You don't hear that. That just, like, drops that low-end noise built into the microphone, which is really nice. Swivel mount has a nice carry bag. I'll show you what that carry bag looks like. So you have this nice, I don't know if it's leather, but it looks like leather. So you have this nice carry bag that it comes in. And I mentioned this little adapter. So depending on the type of mic stand you're using, this goes into the part that actually connects to the mic stand. Little owner's manual here. And overall, I would say I really like this. I may actually start using this. A lot of times when I do my demos, in post, I have to go remove that floor noise, that background noise. I'm not hearing it in the headphones. Of course, I'm going to edit the video and check out the playback, but I'm not hearing it at all. This sounds really focused, which I really like. Let's go to the condenser. Okay, so if you keep your eye on the monitor, you could see that I removed the dynamic, and now we are just going to hear the condenser. This is called the Skylight. I'm gonna bring the volume up a tiny bit more. Hang on. I feel like I was talking way too close to it. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. There we go. This one here is the Skylight. It's a large diaphragm condenser microphone. This is designed for voice applications, capturing vocals with exceptional clarity and warmth. And I'm assuming I'm going to hear that in the playback. Again, I'm monitoring my own audio right now, and it sounds warm, crisp, full-bodied, which I like. It has a vintage-inspired 34-millimeter gold-plated capsule for rich, modern sound. Professional quality to your podcasts, live streams, vocal recordings. Same thing, it's XLR. It comes with this here. I might move this a little bit so you could see. This is a really impressive, the way this whole thing connects. In fact, I might go back. That one's not on. I might go back to this and take this apart. I was really impressed with the overall construction of this, even this pop filter. So when I'm done telling you about this, I'll go back to the dynamic, I'll kill this, and I'll take this off, and I'll show you what that looks like. But there's a metal mesh pop filter, again, for those unwanted plosives. Shock mount rejects vibration-induced sonic artifacts. I love some of the wording in the bullet points here. XLR, great for podcasts, broadcasts, and studio recordings alike. Again, condenser, so you will need power to this 48 volt phantom power, which I'm running to this right over here. Now, there's two other things I want to tell you about briefly. One of them are the headphones that I'm wearing right here. 512, okay? These are $99. They're comfortable. What I'm hearing is very clear, which I like. 45 millimeter drivers, captures nuances in voice and vocals, ideal for podcasting, recording, streaming, or broadcasting, and it is completely isolating everything around me. These are meant to isolate everything around you. It completely goes over your ear and seals it real nice, but it doesn't feel like it's crushing my head, which is nice. It comes with two wires, a coiled and a straight. One is 9.8 feet. The other one is 4.9 feet. Why is that? How do they come up with 9.8 feet or 4.9 feet? Leave a comment below if you know the answer to that. Comes with a nice hard case. I'll show you that, and swivel cup, so it packs in real nice. Let me show you the case. It's actually a really nice case. So it comes with this case right here. It also comes with the little adapter, like a 3.5 millimeter to a quarter inch adapter. I'm actually using that right now because my Scarlett, my Claret 8 Pre-X only has a quarter inch. This is the coiled cable that it comes with. I'm using the straight cable and just a really nice case. I'll give you my best Vanna White hands. Oh, it's actually also has the kind of the stamp in there, 512. I'm assuming 512 is the area code. I think that's the area code of at least Austin, maybe all of Texas. I don't know. If there's a Texan in the house, please tell me. But I think that's the area code of Texas. That's my best educated guess. I just thought of that about that just now. Just kind of dawned on me. And the last thing I want to show you is if you don't have, so again, four products that Sweetwater sent over. If you, both of these microphones, actually, let me go back to the dynamic because you've heard a lot out of this one, so hang on. Okay, testing. Testing. Oh, that was a little loud. Okay. We're back to the dynamic microphone. Wow, it's interesting. This definitely does sound more warm. This one sounded very, very crisp, the condenser. Both of these do have pop filters. And in case you have a microphone that doesn't have a pop filter, they make this pop filter right here, which, interestingly enough, on camera, it looks like a fly swatter. what's different about this is it comes with a nice clamp with a gooseneck, but it has a metal mesh screen. Most of the pop filters I've seen have like a layer of what looks like stockings, okay, like a nylon stocking. This is actually a metal mesh, which is interesting because I think they used the metal mesh in both of these, and I like that. Very sturdy. Okay, so that's that. Now let me show you the condenser, and then we'll wrap this video up. So I did unplug this one here. I'm going to take out the XLR from the bottom. Now this comes off of the top. This is one of the like windscreens, I guess you would call it, which is really nice. It's like and you could see there's a metal that is mesh, and that just pops onto the microphone itself, and this unscrews. So this is the microphone, really just an impressive microphone. And you could also see for like all the noise rejection, it has metal mesh inside. I'll see if, yeah, you could see that's metal mesh inside. And that's, assuming it's the same material. So a really nice microphone. And even the shock mount that it comes with is impressive. I'm going to take it off to show you. It's very cool. So this is like a steel cage, some sort of metal cage. And what's interesting is the metal is attached by these little like bungee cords. So you have a metal frame holding the microphone inside and a metal frame outside. And if I move that ever so slightly, you could see that this, there you go. So normally these type of cages are just a lot of mesh. It almost looks like a tennis racket of sorts with a lot of bungee cord. There's a lot more metal and a lot less bungee cord here, which I like. I feel like it protects the microphone because some of those cages are very like wobbly. This one is nice, so I like this a lot. This one, what you see is what you get. This is a, I guess, like top address, so it's picking up right at the top where the other one is picking up on the side. Side address, top address, or front address. So my fellow rockers, really nice microphones in my very humble opinion. I hope you enjoyed this video. I will include some links in the description below. Let me know what you think. Let me know which one is your favorite. And please leave your comments below. Thank you as always for watching my video. I'm going to leave you all off with one of those bad boys right there. Until next time, I'll see you all later. Rock on.